And welcome to the Exactpro channel. If you want to know more about us, please check out our website at exactpro.com and subscribe to our channel so that you're not missing out on the upcoming videos. At Exactpro, we build software to test software, so today we'll cover yet another solution. In previous videos, we've introduced ClearTH, our testing tool for post-trade. Now, ClearTH is adapted for software testing of distributed ledger technology applications built using DAML, the open-source smart contract language created by Digital Asset. DAML provides the capacity to run on top of multiple blockchains, which is a crucial step towards shaping the industry standards for DLT. DAML easily allows parties to mutualize their processes and secure a golden source of truth with built-in privacy. As an open-source and platform-independent smart contract language, DAML enables the developers to write an application once and deploy it anywhere. Today we will have a look at ClearTH test automation of the functional workflow of swaps implemented in the IRS and CDS swaps lifecycle module application based on the common domain model developed by the ISDA Association. Swap as a derivative with great flexibility is actually a very interesting and challenging case, as almost every change in the parameters will result in a different set of potential events and cash payments. So it is necessary to make sure that all the corresponding events are not only generated and can be accepted or applied, but that their creation is in accordance with the specific derivative product that we aim to trade. We decided that a model-based approach would be the best to meet this challenge. So the approach by Exactpro is an effort to build a whole universe of test scenarios as opposed to testing a certain limited number of scenarios, and aims to cover all aspects of the system under test. To study the digital asset swaps application, the Exactpro team built a separate Excel model describing first the type of the swap contract, for example, IRS, basis swap, or equity swap, or CDS, and the structure of the fields and possible variations. And second, the test scenario specifics, for example, segregation of trades or multiple contracts held by one member, time travel schedule, which events are supposed to be there, etc. So this model is used as a template for test scenario generation. Beside this template, there are spreadsheets containing input data to be added into it. A configuration file with different variations for groups of parameters, and spreadsheets with reference data about participants and their master agreements, accounts, etc., and market data, for example, Reuters feed for floating rate fixings. Both template and the input data files are in a human readable format. Based on this, a programmed function within the model, powered by macros, generates a number of scenarios in the form of CSV matrices, which are the scripts that can be executed by ClearTH. So ClearTH takes the hundreds of scenarios generated within this approach, groups them by the scenario steps, then executes concurrently against the application to see if there are any defects and produces the reports.
For the demo, we have a scenario where ClearTH simulates a participant who connects as a party and submits a trade. ClearTH script sets the ledger time to the next fixing date and simulates floating rate fixings by the market data provider. Then it leaps into the future and sets the ledger time to the next reset date, the payment date, and generates derived events, and so on until the swap maturity. On different stages, ClearTH checks whether the swap's lifecycle is going correctly and whether the different events are produced in the system as expected.
So let's see a short demo. To start, let's have a look at the Excel model mimicking the participant structure and the instrument structure of swaps. This model also allows the user to create individual test cases, either manually or by generating random scenarios using the swaps reference data available. Here, the user just produced 10 scenarios based on one model template, and they input data with parameters combinations, so 10 traits will be uploaded into the system. During a real-life test run, there are hundreds or even thousands of scenarios. Also, in contrast to what is shown in the demo, most of the tests are run as a part of the CI/CD pipeline rather than being manually uploaded into the system. The test scenarios are uploaded to ClearTH, and we can see them under the Matrices tab. In the Configuration and then Scheduler tabs, you can see so-called steps which correspond to certain sets of action within a scenario. The Connectivity section of ClearTH GUI helps to manage the connections. We can see dealers, brokers, and CCPs described by the matrices. The scenarios themselves are keyboard-driven scripts that can be edited manually or, as we already mentioned, generated using the Excel model or, for example, Python model. We can now see them in a CSV file. All 10 automated scripts generated from a template are in different tabs as well as an auxiliary matrix which is created to govern processes affecting all test scenarios. In this case, such a script describes an event of time travel so that we could test certain parts of the swaps lifecycle. So let's launch both applications, the DAML-based swaps application, the right section of the screen, and ClearTH, which is to the left. Now the operational scheduler is starting. It goes from trade upload through multiple stages, and it contains three time shifts that help navigate through the phases. During our test execution, you can notice these ask for continue pop-ups. This is an option, and this allows to check a scenario execution between steps and is used only at the very beginning of the testing activities when it is very important to look at each step separately. In real-life testing, these pop-ups do not appear and the testing is run independently and without interruptions. Then the tool allows the user to view all the messages and all the data frames accessed by the application, and it is possible to check if there are any discrepancies between what we expected and what we actually received right during the test execution. In this particular case, we faked a failure, but if 100 trades were submitted, we could certainly have issues reported stating discrepancies between what we expect and what we actually received. Now it starts to run derived events, the actual instructions for cash transfer, and it will report that there are discrepancies between what we expected and what we received. The discrepancy that is reported here resulted from the fact that we had introduced errors into the reference data for one of the swaps. So the derived event for it wasn't generated. And as there is no cash transfer event, there are no parameters for that event to put into the comparison table. And this is an example of everything going as expected. The user checks all the tags for a particular message and everything looks really fine here. And here you can see what happens when there is an actual discrepancy between the expected and the actual result of the test. The tool reports the differences in particular data fields and particular message tags. The tool provides full reports in the form of a table as well as in JSON format. Also, the reports can be aggregated, providing the summary and analysis of a number of executed scripts combined. In this short demo, we could see ClearTH automatically triggering different lifecycle events such as cash flow generation, trade execution, novation, termination, and simulating various potential actions of different parties involved in a business process, such as initiating transactions or accepting trades. In addition to the simulation, the ClearTH framework has components that perform checks of the transaction results, including account balance totals, interest rates calculations, and of whether the trade was proposed, accepted, and applied. The ClearTH test automation framework enables users to monitor and control the nodes of the DLT-based post-trade system, as well as re-execute the regression library covering complex multi-step business scenarios. So, thanks for watching and stay tuned for the upcoming videos.